there may be emotional issues, there may be that bucket list that people talk about that needs to be addressed. How many items can you cover? What issues may you be able to resolve or not resolve? So it's important to have the opportunity, I think, to take your focus away from the care possibility to, okay, there's a certain amount of time left. What issues do I really want, or should we really look at talking with mom or dad or the person who is dying? And I think that helps a lot. It also helps in terms of the good death, that the pain component, other shortness of breath, these other symptoms be addressed. And that's where the physicians, the healthcare providers, really need to be on top of and not afraid to open up our medication cabinet and use them in a generous way to take that apart, to allow the setting for family members to spend time. It may be that it can't be possible at home. It needs to be in a hospice setting, sometimes in a hospital setting. In my time, I've had, when I worked in the emergency department, some cases where somebody's come in and the opportunity to go to a hospice hadn't happened, a sudden complication happened, and there's one day left to die. And we worked really hard to try and bring that good death to that one day, which has not been an easy sort of thing, but it involves giving the families sort of a clear sense of what's happening, dealing with that suffering, and then giving them a chance to be there with their relative, knowing that we've taken away the symptoms that might be there. That compresses the essence really into one day. Maybe when there are weeks or months, there's more time to deal with some of the other issues. A trip away, being able to read a book, to finish drinking your wine collection, to give some of it away, some of these things.